One way I've always felt more connected to older Dubai.
Mm-hmm.
Like rest of the world just focuses on the glamour and the glitz of this. I feel that the foundational coast and those boats and those things are just very important to me. I started from Amritsar. I was very enterprising at that time, thinking ke agar restaurant kholna to ghar ke piche hona chahiye aur kisi ko kiraya nahi dena padega. And bhature chhole and fried paneer is the only two things the world eats. This is what I grew up and thinking about. But I graduated from Manipal later because my chacha ji took me to Delhi to see how actual restaurants look like. And after graduation, I got a lot of opportunities to work with hotels, Taj, Welcome Group, like Oberoi's. And I think Leela's gave me the first job as a platform in Bombay in 1994. But eventually I felt, you know, I started small banquets back home. I must help my mom because she's running that entirely herself with my grandmother. I go back, I ran it and expanded it like crazy. Mm-hmm. And I actually thought that's the end of my career. And then I had a little hiccup with the government official in 2000, and they destroyed my entire banquets. I decided to go to America. I worked in New York and went to schools and did everything.
Mm-hmm.
All the 8 yards of typical American dream. Did that, and then in 2008 the meltdown happened, which, you know, the entire American economy became nothing.
Mm-hmm.
That at that time all my businesses were wiped out, from cooking school to restaurant in Midtown and to catering company. Then I figured out that my biggest aspiration to come to America was to win a Michelin star, and I should only focus on that and not expand so much. I think the one thing of having a restaurant in Dubai is also you get a major exposure between Europe, Asia, and now we see a big footfall of Americans here. And for me, I feel that that is considerably an amazing platform. It's like a stage for us. And it also helps us to promote the culture, the cuisine, and the ideas behind what we do as Indian chefs. But at Kinara, what I wanted to do, I wanted to create something which is just like an extension of a dining room.
Okay.
Though it's extremely beautiful, and we figured out that, you know, what we need to do. It took us many years to make this. We figured out that people should be able to enjoy Indian food as if the comfort of their home. And many people keep asking me, but your food doesn't look so Indian. I'm like, you know what? Take a bite and close your eyes and tell me if it's not Indian.
Okay.
This is what I challenge you. I feel that for a dish, you feel is like a painting. You know, one time the artist, when we're talking about, could be through Renaissance or, you know, modern era, one time the artist have to figure out that is the painting complete or do I still need to give it strokes? I'm always confused. Plating is same for me. You know, I always feel ke main kuch aur kar sakta hu isme. Can I add something more to it or maybe take something out so that I don't lose the essence or the soul of the dish? Constant war. And you know, yesterday night I dreamt of a dish, and today, since afternoon, we are trying to perfect that.
Wow.
I think at Kinara you will feel that there are many dishes which you can only have here, which are regional, which are, we try our best. And they also, people have their regular favorites, which, you know, all the diners in the world have. When I'm going to an Italian restaurant or Vietnamese restaurant, this is my favorite dish.
Yeah.
I'm going to try that. So I say, come and try your favorite dish, and but also give a chance to discovering your new favorites.
Okay.
Because we are constantly adding to the menu. We're constantly adding new ways to express more Indian regional cuisine in the dining room.